Hello, fans, and welcome to tonight's game between the North Carolina Wilmington Seahawks and the Duke Blue Devils. And, of course, we look here at our Star Watch. What's the starting five look like, you might ask? Well, whether it's a big game or a small game, your starting five has got to be ready to go, Dick.
Keep your eyes on these two small forwards, Brad. They're both very talented, and you can expect to see them go at each other all game long.
I think we're ready for the tip. Duke gets the ball and begins their threat. The Blue Devils are number 9 in the polls right now, Dick.
You know what it boils down to, Brad, is you've got to be efficient on the perimeter to be able to be up there with the elite.
So, Dick, so important now at the point. The point guard will set things up and the other four will go to work.
Well, you know what they're doing is a four around with a post guy on the interior, and they're trying to get that ball to the inside, but they're playing with four people on the exterior.
Both teams looking to get things going here. They'll work it around the arc. He lets it fly. Gets the J to fall.
Excellent spacing. That's so important to a good offensive set. It's even more important to have talented guards like they have.
Yeah, that helps. Turnover committed by the freshman. Top of the circle, they work it around the perimeter. Trying to feed inside. For the bucket. Sinks it.
Defense breaks down again. Nobody rotates over from the help side.
Work the perimeter.
Spacing so important. Get 15 to 17 feet apart.
He gets the bucket to fall. Nice to have you along with us tonight. Dick Vitale and Aaron Andrews alongside. I'm Brad Nessler. We got a good one going. They're working around the perimeter. For two. Gets it to fall. How about that drive to the hoop, Dick?
He had one thing on his mind, and that was getting to the goal. Mission accomplished.
Way out on top, controlling the ball. Puts up the J. It'd be nice if he could get some assistance out there. That young man is doing it all for his team right now.
He's doing it all right now for this team. It'll be interesting to see if he can keep this up.
On the dribble, gives it up. Goes up. Scorches the net with a J. Cross court. He shoots from the elbow. They get it to go.
Trying to get that ball movement, get that good spacing. Uncharacteristic mistake by the senior.
Looking to move it around the perimeter. Uncharacteristic mistake by the senior. Looking for a good shot. In the lane. They got it. You can see the frustration as he picks up the foul.
Oh, that's a bad, bad foul right there, Brad.
Number 11 receives the ball. Jumper knocks it down.
Look at that spacing.
Allen's lowly performance has just gotten in his head.
Brad, he's in what many people call a funk. Emotionally, he's got to turn things around. Up and inside.
We approach 10 seconds now on the shot clock.
Jumper didn't look pretty, I can tell you that. That baby was ugly.
They work it around the perimeter. He puts up the J and come up short. From the corner, perfectly executed. Gave it up. Takes the medium range jumper. Nails the J. As the fans chant.
Who says there's no such thing as a home court advantage? Turnover by the senior.
On the wing. And has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with that blocked shot.
Sinks the shot. Working it around the perimeter. Puts it on the floor and up and under. Can't connect. Puts up the tray. Off the mark. For the bucket. No good. Isolated on the outside. They're working around the arc looking for the open jumper. Bust the J. Now they work it around the perimeter.
Excellent jump shot right there.
Robinson handles the pass. He shoots from the top of the key. Missed it.
And the fans love it, man. They love it. Our house, baby, our house.
Cross court. Puts it on the floor and up and under. Missed the jumper. Allen handles the pass. Inside. There's a high percentage shot.
Wow, what hops, baby, what hops.
Moving it around the perimeter.
Turnover committed by the senior.
Ball's going to stay here. down the left side. He takes the three. Nope. Pushes it up. For two. There was no doubt about that one. He hammers it home.
You can almost see that coming. They were a little bit lazy on the defensive end. Mr. Excitement with that jam.
Goaltending. That trap could spell some trouble. Allen handles the feed. Number one with the foul. First team foul. Well, I don't know if there's such a thing as a good foul, but that might have been one right there, Dick.
Hey, Mr. Nessler, I like that type of play. He's saying to the defense, no easy baskets for you. We're going to force you to make shots.
Another great sophomore right here, Dick.
He may be young, but if he's on the floor for this team, you know he's willing and able to contribute any way he can.
Got him trapped here, Dick.
Hey, they got him in some trouble, Brad.
Way out on top, controlling the ball. Now they run the other way. He's too important to this team to be picking up fouls like that. Well, he commits an intentional foul there to prevent the easy basket.
Well, it's a smart play, Brad, especially if you can afford to use a personal foul. I like his mentality. No easy basket. You know, seniors are important because they bring so much to the team. Leadership, motivation, and a sense of accountability. It's their last year, so you know they want to make it a memorable one.
Sinks both of them. They've got him trapped. Two-man action. On the outside. From left of the circle. Nails a sweet jumper. They work the perimeter. He throws it up from downtown. They get it to go. He's going to see this guy in his sleep tonight, Dick.
He's already living a nightmare, Brad.
The shooting guard receives the pass. And a momentary look from three-point land. Allen picks up the foul. Second team foul. Oh, it looked like he had an easy basket coming up, but the defense commits the foul instead.
Great play there, Brad. He was able to foul him in order to prevent the easy basket.
The Seahawks will step to the line for the first time. He buries it. Got them both.
He converts on that free throw line, and that's major.
Traps in place, Dick. And it's dripped. Active hands. The shooting guard handles the feed. And now they'll bring it up. Here comes the ball screen. Turnover committed by the senior. On the low block, takes the jumper. And nice looking jumper in the lane.
Gotta take some pride on the defensive end.
The small forward handles the feed. On the dribble, gives it up. With a J. Bust the jumper. The Seahawks got some good ball reversal there.
I'll tell you, that's great offensive execution. Doing a great job at running their stuff. The ball reversal going to the opposite side, and then they're able to convert.
Off the mark. Goes. Number zero handles the feed. Looking for a good shot. He shoots from the corner. Scores it. And there's sort of a snapshot of our game tempo.
These teams are selectively pushing the ball and looking for transition opportunities.
Tries for two. Off the glass and no good. Out on the wing. He rejects it. On the right side. On the outside. For the bucket. He makes the shot. The shooting guard with the ball. Pushes it up. About 7 minutes remaining on the game clock. For two, off the glass and no good. They'll work it around the arc. It's stolen. Goes up for two. That is a dagger in the heart, that shot, Dick.
Hey, they lost focus here. They need a timeout to regroup, Rod.
Fed the low block. Puts up the jumper. The missed shot. Out of bounds, and we're not going anywhere. Let's take a look at this young guy's great performance tonight, Vic.
He's a PTP-er, Brad, a prime-time performer, a really talented kid. He knows the game, and is showing everyone how much he loves playing.
Here we go. We'll stay right here. The inbounds play. About 6 minutes remaining on the game clock. Out on the wing. On the elbow, they feed down to the low block. He gets the layup to go and the foul.
What a hoop. He saw the defender coming and tried to go right through him.
Here's another solid junior, Dick.
Hey, I tell you, juniors and seniors are valuable pieces in any college basketball puzzle. Having experienced kids like this on the court and on the bench can take a lot of pressure off the coaching staff.
Tries for two. Off the glass and no good. A personal foul. Well, if there is such a thing as a good foul, that was probably it.
Sure was, Brad. He fouled to prevent the easy basket.
Opportunity now for an easy one. Gets the first. Got them both. They're seeing them all fall from the line tonight.
That's a crucial plus down the stretch, Brad.
Inside for the bucket. Gets it to go. Gave it up. About 5 minutes remaining in the game clock.
Excellent spacing. That's so important to a good offensive set. It's even more important to have talented guards like they have.
Yeah, that helps. Goes up with a shot. Knocked it down. Worked the perimeter.
Spacing so important. Get 15 to 17 feet apart.
Can't connect. On the dribble, gives it up. He shoots from downtown.
Jumper didn't look pretty, I can tell you that. That baby was ugly.
And now the fadeaway jumper.
You talk about versatility. Aren't many guys that are going to make that fadeaway jump shot. Great touch. Impossible to block that shot.
They work it around the perimeter. He bombs from outside and score it.
Trying to get that ball movement, get that good spacing. They strip him of the basketball. Got a little too fancy, too much mustard there.
Jumper. Missed the jumper. Going to move it around the perimeter. He makes the block. Blocked. Pushes it up. 3 minutes left in the game clock. Pull up jumper, left side. Missed it. Looking for a good shot. Tries for two, knocks it down.
There's the trap.
Goes up with it. Off the mark. Way out on the right wing. Puts up the J. Nails the jumper.
That spacing
for the bucket. Scorches the net.
Up and inside.
He attempts the jump shot. Nails the J. Brian, known as more of a slasher, isn't he, Dick?
I'll tell you what, he's really showing some great ability here. Just does a great job attacking the rim. I tell you, you gotta really, really like this kid.
They work it around the perimeter. Takes his jumper. Scorches the net with a J. One minute left to go. Working it around the perimeter. And the block. He cleans the glass. For two. That was nice. How about that drive to the hoop, Dick?
Doing a wonderful job putting the ball on the floor and getting into the painted area.
Gave it up. He puts up the three ball. They get it to go. gets the rejection. No. At halftime, the Blue Devils lead by 6. Duke found themselves shooting very well, Dick, in that first half.
Hey, that's a true sign of a well-coached team and a mature team. And we don't see too many mature teams. They're not mature like you, Mr. Nestler.
Number one, quickly checking back in.
They need him out there, Brad, just like I need you, man. This guy is the glue.
On the dribble, gives it up.
Great pressure, great double team, really explosive.
Isolated on the outside, they work it around the arc, looking for the open jumper. He puts up the tray, knocked it down. Looking for the pick now.
Hey, the two-man game is great to watch when you have an intelligent dribble.
Great block shot.
Bring it hard or don't bring it at all.
Gave it up. Up, bust the jumper. Now they work it around the perimeter. He pulls up with a jumper, scores it. With the jumper,
excellent jump shot right there.
Moving it around the perimeter. Goes up for 2. He gets it to fall. He shoots the jumper. They got it. There's a look at the current tempo for the game.
Two teams who are picking and choosing when they want to push the ball, Brad.
On the left side, takes the jumper, off the mark. Dumps it in. He fades away. He misses the fadeaway. There they come with a double team to stop it. Tries for 2, drains the shot.
Try to go inside.
The turn, a fadeaway jumper, and come up short. Feed.
Great effort defensively. He says, thou shalt not enter thy lane, baby. Get it out of here. I'm the landlord.
Now with about 10 seconds to shoot. For the bucket. He hits the shot. inside for two. He drains the shot.
A great backdoor pass right there, Dick.
Hey, when you can mix teamwork and execution, you get plays like that, Mr. Nestler.
He shoots from the deep corner. The Blue Devils have found a player who cannot seem to miss, Dick.
Brady's on fire.
Cross court. With the J.
Jumper didn't look pretty, I can tell you that. That baby was ugly.
Ingram handles the pass. On the outside. Loose ball saved. Goes up for two. Got it. Ball's going to stay here. It's been a great team effort for these guys tonight, Dick.
You can't have any weak links out there at this level. The coaches and players are just too good, and they'll be exposed. So far, it's been a demonstration of teamwork here today. Team now, Matt Angle.
On the dribble, gives it up. He blocks the shot. On the left side. Tries for two. Off the mark. Trying to feed the low block. Jumper. Jumper won't go. They work the perimeter. It's not smart to just throw it out of bounds. And that's one too many turnovers.
Yeah, those turnovers are really a nightmare, especially when they lead to layups.
Bucket. He gets the bucket. A nice job of getting to the hole right there, Dick.
That's a great job, Brad. Using his athleticism to get to the hoop and convert.
Turnover by the senior. Number one gets the ball. He shoots from the corner. He knocks down the jumper. He shoots from right of the circle. Knocks it down. Momentary look from three-point land. Lets it fly. Doesn't go. From the top of the circle. Off the mark.
It looks as though they have a shooter spotting up.
Two off the glass and no good. Allen handles the pass. Jumper busts the J. Seahawks are getting some great opportunities to score when they get the ball in the high post.
They got the ball into the high post, and the defense couldn't react on time, Brad.
Tries for two. He nails the shot. Had a guy in the post, but elected to reverse the ball. Too physical. Well, I don't know if there's such a thing as a good foul, but that might have been one right there, Dick.
Hey, Mr. Nessler, I like that type of play. He's saying to the defense, no easy baskets for you. We're going to force you to make shots.
You know, when a team shoots this well from the line, playing aggressive defense can come back to haunt you.
Well, you know, when a team shoots a high percentage from the foul line, it means that they realize the importance of free throws.
Got them both.
Oh, he drained it. Nothing but nylon, NBN.
They've got him right where they want him, Richard. The glass and no good. That's good. Gave it up.
Coach looks on. Focused, a lot of intensity, a lot of emotion.
He puts up the J.
Run him right at the screen again. What did I say?
To get it to the inside. Puts up the jumper. Knocked it down. Looking for a good shot.
Nice hops. Hey, when a team's hot, they're hot, baby.
The defense putting in a great effort, but it's just not getting it done. On the outside.
He's got hops like you, man. He got hops like you.
Yeah, it is pretty similar.
Wow. I didn't realize my partner was a high riser.
For two. Off the glass and no good. Goes in. That's taking it strong to the hoop, right, Dick?
That's a great take, Brad. That puts pressure on the defense when you go to the hoop like that.
They'll work it around the arc. And now the fadeaway jumper. Can't connect. On the dribble, gives it up. Ten seconds on the shot clock. Turnaround jumper. Nope. As we continue to track the game's tempo.
A little half-court action and a little fast breaking, Brad. As a result, we have a balanced tempo reading.
And we'll get a change of possession.
Excellent spacing. That's so important to a good offensive set. It's even more important to have talented guards like they have.
Yeah, that helps. The Blue Devils are going to try to hold on to the lead here, but should probably do so by playing in the half court as opposed to that up-tempo style, Dick.
Hey, these guys aren't known for being a half-court team. However, at this point, with the time and score where it is, it'd be smart for them to have longer offensive possessions, which keep the clock running.
The shooting guard gets the pass. Here comes a pick.
Hey, ball screens are such an important part of the game these days. Guys are so creative when it comes to using that ball screen.
Well, he commits an intentional foul there to prevent the easy basket.
Well, it's a smart play, Brad, especially if you can afford to use a personal foul. I like his mentality. No easy basket. If you want to know how aggressive a team is, you check to see how many times they go to the free throw line. That's a great indicator.
It's two at the charity stripe.
The Seahawks
might be in trouble here, Dick. It might be time to abandon any half-court sets and look at getting some baskets in transition.
It's all about quick shots now, Brad. They're going to have to get stops and then quick scores to overcome this deficit.
Here's a double team. Here they go in transition. And it's knocked away. Great block. Work the perimeter.
Spacing so important. Get 15 to 17 feet apart.
About 7 minutes remaining on the game clock. Makes the shot. Two. Dick, he's in a serious rhythm.
Hey, that's because he's getting the ball in rhythm, Brad. Very important.
Allen handles the pass. Unloads. Missed it. He gets the shot to fall. Dumps it in. Puts it on the floor and up and under.
That's a good post play because the footwork was excellent. So many guys walk with their pivot foot. He does a great job showing ball fake, and good footwork keeping his pivot foot down.
About 6 minutes remaining. Jumper! They got it.
Trying to get that ball movement, get that good spacing.
Tries for two with a layup. Cross court. He wants a three. The shot won't fall. He drains it. Going to move it around the perimeter.
Bad decision there by the freshman.
And again, they look to run. For the bucket. You betcha. 5 minutes left in the game clock. Looking for a good shot. For two. The missed shot. They'd like to get it inside to the low block. Nails a sweet jumper.
The Seahawks like to play a half-court style, Dick. What types of players do they usually attract to their program?
They'll never force a shot and will rarely get into a running game, Brad. They realize that they can't play that style and be successful. Nice low post play, good entry to the box.
He attempts a jump shot.
Frustration right there. Is that pressure on that basketball?
We're at the 4 minute mark. Goes up for two. It sticks. He tries to knock down the three. Missed the jumper.
Look at that spacing.
Seconds.
off the mark. There's the tempo for the game thus far.
We've seen a combination of both short and long possessions here, Brad. Nothing wrong with that if that's your team's ideal style of play.
They get it to go. About 3 minutes remaining on the game clock. Cross court. Fans will be celebrating tonight, Dick. This one's out of reach.
Well, it's simple. They came out, executed a game plan, and ended up on top.
Ten to shoot now. Tries for two. Off the glass and no good. Gave it up. With it. Nails the J.
Up and inside.
Short, and the ball goes out of play. Points in the paint are huge, and these guys have really been coming up big in that category.
Hey, the points in the paint have been huge for them, Brad. Winning the battle in the paint will win you games. It's obvious that that's where they're looking to attack.
Gives it up.
Unusual mistake there by the senior.
Uncharacteristic mistake by the senior. Now on the run. From the corner. Not a great decision there to shoot the ball.
Hey, Brad, their shot selection has been questionable. Too many outside jumpers. They've got to attack inside and then out.
For the bucket. Great shot. Gave it up. He shoots from the deep corner. About a minute remaining in the game. Swatted away. Allen handles the pass. Fires away. Knocked it down. Floor. ESPN's coverage of the NCAA will continue after this. And we're ready to get things back going again after the timeout. Number zero gets the ball. He unloads a three.
And the bricks just keep on coming, baby.
I have to start looking for some easier baskets here, Dick. Top of the circle, they work it around the perimeter. Tickles a twine. Shot clock is dead. Working around the perimeter. Here's the three ball. Bust the J.
Great strength on that drive.
Well, he spotted an opening, and he just absolutely great first step, and he exploded to the goal.
Working it around the perimeter. Puts it on the floor and up and under.
Nope.
He had to hurry it. He comes up empty. Duke comes away with a huge win tonight in this blowout.
Well, they came into favorites, and it did not disappoint.
That's going to do it for us, folks. Thanks for being along. For Dick Vitale and Aaron Andrews, I'm Brad Nessler.